So let us go to this inside the heart. We have around the heart a kind of a, if as a kind of a shirt is there, there is a kind of a layer on the heart. This layer, if it gets inflamed, this also can cause pain. This is called pericardial pain. Sometimes the fluid can collect around the heart. This can also cause pericardial. This can also cause pain. So, but these are not heart pains. Pericardial pains are similar to heart pains, but they are not dangerous pains. A doctor can diagnose this easily by seeing an ECG and probably echocardiogram. Now we also know that both there are lungs on either side of the heart. When the lungs get infected with a pneumonia, this can cause pain. Pneumonia can cause acute chest pain, which is similar to the heart pain. But this kind of people will have a fever, cough, sputum, and increase in the pain during breathing, and they will be excessively tachypneic. That means they will be taking a lot of deep breaths. So a pneumonia in the lung or infection in the lung, a large infection can cause chest pain, but you will have fever and cough and sputum. So and then sometimes a lung can collapse because of air around the heart or because of the water around the lung. The lung can collapse. This lung collapse either because of the air around the lung or due to the water around the lung can also cause pains. And these are also simple pains which can be diagnosed by chest x-ray and a physician will help you. These are again not heart pains, these are something to do with lung. So what I am trying to tell you is that the moment somebody gets a chest pain, one need not always worry that it is something to do with the heart. Always it can be because of different reasons, different origins, different organs, and most of them are not so serious as heart disease. Now coming down to the esophagus, the food pipe. Once you eat food, the food goes to the food pipe or esophagus to the stomach in the abdomen. Okay. This is not one of the commonest pains you have. See, in this gentleman, there is a kind of a increased acidity, increased acid in the stomach, and this acid refluxes, goes up to the throat and causes a diffuse burning pain. This is called as GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disorder, or a gastritis or a reflux esophagitis. This is a very common pain. Most of these pains start about half an hour to 1 hour after food, because as you eat food, the acid becomes produced to digest the food, and these people, there is a kind of a sphincter here, this kind of a sphincter or a muscle here, which usually restricts our food going up into the esophagus. In some people, the sphincter, the muscle bundle may not be tight and it may be little loose, so the stomach contents goes up. This causes a lot of burning pain in the chest. These kind of people will get a significant relief with antacid gels, taking some kind of a syrups or chewing some tablets. Or these people get some kind of relief. These pains does not increase with exertion. Usually come after food, and they subside over a period of time, and they repeatedly come. They sometimes people get some belchings, eructations. Sometimes these patients will get a relief after vomiting because you are emptying the stomach. There is a soft organ behind the stomach called as pancreas. Pancreas can give pain, which can be felt in the lower chest or upper abdomen. This happens in alcoholics and stone disease people. On the right side, there is a liver, and gallbladder stones can cause pain. Sometimes these people can have pain in the chest as well, apart from the upper abdomen right side. It is usually said that heart pain does not go down the umbilicus. It can be felt up to umbilicus, but any pain that goes below umbilicus is something to do with the stomach and abdomen, not with the heart. The psychogenic pains are a set of pains which is basically because of a severe anxiety. So these are called as psychosomatic disorders, where an intense anxiety, stressful states, they manifest this kind of a stress in the form of a physical pain. So they get kind of a pain. I have seen some people getting panicky with significant pain without any kind of a origin from the tissues around this chest area. This is called as psychogenic pains. And psychogenic pains can happen because of the stress, anxiety, depression, and multiple other reasons. The psychogenic pains also we are seeing nowadays when the people who had seen a death in their family, in their colleagues, in their cousins who died all of a sudden at a young age, these people become very panicky, and they also think that they mirror their symptoms, and they come with a panic that my colleague has died, my brother has died, my cousin has died at a very young age, I'm getting similar pain. They come with such kind of a panic. So panic disorders, somatizations, anxieties also can come with chest pain. We need to probably think about it. There's another type, another syndrome called D'Acosta syndrome. These are kind of a psychogenic pain only. These people will have a pain at one particular place just below the breast, and then this pain increases with respiration, and they have a severe significant pain which usually subsides once you assure them. So these can also can have hyperventilation, dyspnea, and they feel become, you know, very panicky. They start breathing, hyperventilating. They think it's just something to do with going with the hand, but usually these pains are very localized pains, not more than area of fingertip, and usually below the left breast, and usually there are other signs of anxiety along with these kinds of pains. The other pain which is not unusual is a herpes zoster, what we call as a kind of a viral infection affecting the skin in the chest. Herpes zoster can happen anywhere in the body, but it can usually happen in the chest region. If it happens in the left side chest, we can have a similar kind of a severe pain. Unless we examine the skin in that area, and we make it a point to see whether skin is healthy or not.